Okay, now that we've got a async function which is loading our to-dos for us, which will tell us if it errors, we need to work out how to take those to-dos and display them in our UI. Because it's all very well like them being returned from here, but we can't actually like display them yet. All we're saying is that the to-dos have loaded. And there I just deleted the buttons sort of manually working the UI. So in order to kind of save this information to our machine, we're going to need to utilize a new concept. And that concept is context. And context, if I just remove these events from the schema just there, context is an object and it's basically like a key value store where you can store anything you need to store in your machine. And our context, we're going to add two things to it. We're going to say to-dos, which is an array, and I'm going to say as an array of strings. And this as just helps XState understand sort of what's contained within our context. And this context is also the initial sort of context, really, the thing that we start with, kind of like the initial state if you've ever used use state before. So we've got our to-dos, and we also might need an error message as well. And we're going to say this is undefined as string or undefined, because sometimes we'll have an error and sometimes we won't. So we've got our context here. How do we then kind of like assign things to the context? How do we set things into the context? Well, we use the assign action. XState has several built-in actions that you can use in order to kind of assign things to context, to send events, to do sort of more powerful things. And you can import them from assign in XState here. So inside our ondone, that's the moment where we're going to have our to-dos available to us. So we're going to call an action in there. Again, actions are something that takes zero time. And so assigning to the context, that's a zero time action. So we're going to call assign here. Or in fact, we're going to actually just give this a name. We'll say assign to-dos to context. And when we save that, it adds it into our visualization here, which is pretty cool. So we'll then add this into our second argument of use machine, where we have actions, assign to-dos to context, context event. And you'll notice here that I'm passing a function to the assign call there. And this basically, this is what tells XState what to do to assign the function. And in an assign function, you always need to return a partial of the new context. So we're going to say return. And inside here, we're going to say to-dos are the event dot. Now this event is the thing that's returned from our load to-dos invocation here. And you can notice that the data that gets returned is on the data property. So this is the list of to-dos there. And we also probably need to do the same thing for the error here, right? Because we're assigning the result of the success to context, but we're not assigning the result of the error. So in order to do that, we're going to add actions, assign error to context. And let's save that. And then we're going to go assign error to context is assign context event. And we'll say return error message event.data. And this one is tricky because it's actually unknown. So when an error is thrown in your application, we generally don't know kind of what shape it's going to be. And this is true for when you use try catch or anything like that. So we're going to wrap this in a pair of parentheses and say it's as an error. And we're going to say the message is going to be assigned to context there. So to go over that, what we've done is we have, when we load the to-dos and we're done with them, then we assign the to-dos to context. When an error occurs, then we assign the error to context instead. And that's the idea. We use the assign function for that. So when we then go into index.tsx, we can now go, okay, we've got our state.value here, but then I'm going to just wrap this in a pre tag here, just to give it a nice bit of formatting. We can also go pre json.stringify state.context as well. And so we've got JSON stringify state.context, JSON stringify state.value. That means that when we load the to-dos, because this function at the moment can never fail the way we've written it, we should have take bins out and do laundry inside our initial context. So let's refresh the page and boom, there we go. We've got our state value and we've got our state context. If we throw an error inside here, throw new error, oh no, then if we refresh the page. Then we have oh no in our error message, which is really cool. So what we have is we have a top level context. And by the way, context can only live at the root of your machine. So it's a context for the entire machine, not for individual states. And we grab that state context and we display it in our application and we use assign to assign to it.